But allow your heart to receive the grace of Sabbath, the grace of God's intrusion into our busyness, the grace of God's holy interruption of all our planning and timing. Very special welcome to our musicians tonight, of whom at least two didn't even know they would be here tonight 4 days ago. Welcome to Elizabeth Gillogly, to Thom Greathouse, Walt Strony, and Anne, who once again had to change program on the whim and bring in new musicians, and I'm glad you did. You might have noticed the different lyrics to the carol O Come Emmanuel. You see, there was a time in the church when Israel was not understood as a state, a nation with a geographic location in this earth, on this world, right? There was a time, well, that O Come Emmanuel goes back to the 7th century, 8th century, 9th century, long time ago, right? It was way after Israel ceased to exist and way before it came to be a state, a nation again. We understood it for a long time as a metaphor for all who are mourning in exile, who are aware of their brokenness and who are waiting for God's redemptive task. At this time of war between Israel and Hamas, it would not be prudent to use these old words that easily could be misunderstood, because God does not take sides, but God is always at the side of all who are suffering, of all who are hurting, and all who are grieving the death of loved ones, no matter what state or nation or religion they belong to. Now I invite you to sing together with me and everyone here the Christmas carol once in royal cages.
Thank you.
But then when the hymn talks about the actually what the ship is bringing and how it's being driven, all of a sudden the melody picks up, changes, and excitement comes into that melody, announcing that the ship carries a very special load. The Son of God, the eternal Word of the Heavenly Father. Christian tradition has compared Mary, Jesus' mother, with a ship that brings joy into the world already since the 4th century, bearing the most precious cargo, heaven's most valuable treasure, Jesus the Christ, the Son of God. And the driving force of this coming, of God's coming into this world, is love. The sail, the mast that actually drives the ship. The love to God's creation. The love to those who are lost. The love that doesn't want to be separated from the loved ones. It's a coming like no other. God bending down so low. God's child joining us where we're us who are lost. Not avoiding the pain and suffering of the world, and yet working our redemption for good. To Advent, the season before Christmas, is a season of waiting, and a season that can help us to again learn to be patient, learn to wait, and to trust the gentle working of the Spirit. It's an invitation to pause, to let things go, to accept the slower pace, even if only for a while, and to receive what God has sent our way.
Thank you.
after a long time of waiting. There's a prayer in the prophet Isaiah to God for coming through, praising God for coming through, finally coming through and coming to the aid of the people. O Lord, you are my God, I will exalt you. I will praise your name, for you have done wonderful things, plans formed of old, faithful and sure. For you have been a refuge to the poor, a refuge to the needy in their distress, a shelter from the rainstorm and a shade from the heat. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will make for all peoples a feast of rich food, a feast of well-aged wines, of rich food filled with the marrow, of well-aged wines strained clean. And he will destroy on his mountains the shroud that it casts over all peoples, the sheet that is spread over all nations. He will swallow up death forever. Then the Lord God will wipe away the tears from all faces, and the disgrace of the people he will take away from all the earth, for the Lord has spoken. It will be said on that day, lo, this is our God. We have waited for him so that he might save us. This is the Lord for whom we have waited. Let us be glad and rejoice in his salvation. I invite you to sing, O Little Town of Bethlehem.
Thank you.
May God grant you time. Time to rest. Time to be. Time to listen. To re-energize. And time to live. May God come to you like the gentle breeze of wind, carrying the scent of God's love that can't be kept away. May your waiting be filled with expectation and see already coming what has not yet arrived. May your rejoicing be great when God comes to you and steps into your life today. May your Christmas be joyful and filled with peace. Amen. Just like to invite you, we'll have one more of these events next Wednesday. Next Wednesday, the focus will be more on Blue Christmas for those who carry, well, sad feelings in this time, in the season of Christmas. And we'll be able to pour these out before God and hear words of comfort and grace. And then Sunday, 10 a.m., well, I guess you figure that usual time of the Sunday worship service. And there's also on Christmas Eve, 4 p.m. service here with some good music.
Thank you for coming. Have a wonderful night. God bless.